Hello, my friends. This is Ralph Emery on the air for Ford Trucks again with my guest, Ray Price. Ray, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Ralph. Glad to be here.
Son, we are all set to get into your life a little bit, play some of your tunes, and coming up on this show will be Nightlife, another great song by you, and then we'll play it by you and Willie on this show. Why don't you bring on one of the new singers?
All right. Here's one that I particularly like to hear, Ralph, because it's a very good singer. Here's Lacey J. Dalton with Hard Times.
Same old bells on the dresser, same old sheets on the bed, same old pans in the kitchen, the same old day old bread, same old sad-eyed newsman on the same old TV set, talking about a big depression. But I ain't worried yet about hard times. Hard times. Hard times is a daddy and a mother living in a mansion and hating each other. Hard times is losing your faith and watching your spirits fall. Hard times is the children too racking their brains about who loves who. We ain't got no hard times at all. Sister's got the same old dolly, brother's got the same old traits, the same old love and laughter, playing the same old games. I know you want to sail the South Seas, and I want to see Paris, but as long as there's a bed to lie in, there's still a lot of sights to see. 'Cause hard times is a daddy and a mother living in a mansion and hating each other. Hard times is losing your faith and watching your spirits fall. Hard times is the children too racking their brains about who loves who. We ain't got no hard times at all. We ain't got no hard times, honey, we ain't got no hard times.
Little Pennsylvania girl, Lacey J. Dalton with Hard Times.
Inflation has made it difficult to own the things you want. And one item missing, sadly missing in many homes, is the family Bible. But now, in time for Christmas giving, we've made arrangements to send you a genuine Regency family Bible. The kind that's normally priced at $39.95. But the total cost to you will be only $12.95. Bound in rich grain simulated white leather with gold stamping, this family Bible has a picture of Christ on the cover. There are 9 pages of full-color photographs of the Holy Land, and 19 pages of full-color art masterpieces. Yes, this Bible is worth $39.95, but we'll send it to you to give your loved ones this Christmas for just $12.95. Please send your check or money order for $12.95 to Christmas Bible, Post Office Box 8R, Nashville, Tennessee 37202. That's Christmas Bible, Post Office Box 8R, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202.
Talking with Ray Price. Ray, I want to remind you of a story. I want you to tell me your side of it. You're at the convention, and maybe you're at a Columbia convention in Miami, and you are the Cherokee Cowboy, and the president of the label is going to introduce you. And what happened?
Well, being from New York, Goddard Lieberson, God love him, he's a fine man. He says, there's Ray Price and the Cherokee Cowboys. And that became a big thing for between Goddard and I. And Goddard and I was very dear friends, and I miss him. He's gone.
Did he do that on purpose, or was that just a mistake?
No, it was just a mistake. And he was trying to do all the MC work, and it was the first time, I'm sure, that he'd ever done it. He was trying to be so, here's the president of the company and he's in front of everybody at the company, so he's got to be right on his toes. Anyway, it turned out to be the laugh of the convention, but it stayed that way for years.
Ray, if I see your show now on stage, what sort of backing will you have? Will you have the lush violins, or will you have the instrumentation of the Cherokee Cowboys?
Well, I have them both. I have finally, through all the years of experiment, have come up with 8 pieces that can play just exactly like any record that I have out.
Do you use that string machine?
It's not a string machine that I use. We use an arp on a keyboard. It's similar. Then the strings that I have are excellent country fiddle players. So we do the old and the new.
Did you say Buddy Emmons was back with you?
Absolutely.
Oh, you know, Buddy Emmons is one of my heroes.
Buddy Emmons, to me, is the greatest steel player ever lived.
Yeah, I have to agree with that.
You know, he really is. And I know a lot of friends of mine that are great steel players, but I have to tell it like it is.
Yeah. He is the Chet Atkins of the steel guitar.
He's solid there.
I think Buddy's going to play on the record we've got coming up here.
Absolutely.
All right, why don't you set this up for us?
All right, this is one that Willie wrote back in the early 60s, and when he was with me, and I recorded it, and he put a half a dozen people's name on this song, but he wrote the song, and it's called Nightlife.
Oh, when the evening sun goes down, you will find me hanging round. Oh, the nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life. Many people just like me dreaming of old used to be. Oh, the nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life. Well, listen to the blues they're playing. Yeah, listen to what the blues are saying. Mine is just another scene from the world of broken dreams. Oh, the nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life.
Evening sun goes down, you will find me hanging around. Nightlife ain't no good life, it's my life. And many people just like me dreaming of old used to be. A nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life. Well, now listen to the blues that they're playing. Listen to what the blues are saying. And mine is just another scene from the world of broken dreams. The nightlife ain't no good life, it's my life. And the night life ain't no good life, but it's my life.
Boy, it gives you a chill to listen to that. Has that been recorded by a rhythm and blues act?
No, I think Ray Charles would murder it.
Yeah, he would. But I don't know.
If I get a chance, I'll call that gentleman and tell him.
But that had the finest feel. I think Emmons had a lot to do with that, too.
Oh, yeah. Got the touch of a master.
And this was a must when the album came up between you and Willie Nelson.
Well, it had to be. It had to be. And we was really digging each other singing. We were singing and enjoying what each other was doing, because our mics was just right here, one over here and one over here. We was back apart. And I was enjoying the way he was working, and he was doing the same way, and that's why this thing turned out like it did. I knew it would, because Willie's a good singer.
Now, his singing style is a little different to yours, though.
Yeah, well, I hope so.
Yeah, Willie used to, when I first heard him, I thought, I can't figure out whether he's talking or singing.
Right, right.
Because his style is so unique.
Well, it's all a relative. Singing and talking is the same, if you can get it all together.
Okay. You've heard Willie Nelson and Ray Price sing Nightlife. From up in Ohio, here's a little Buckeye darling, I call her Margot Smith.
People sure stare at a limousine on the poor side of town. I swore the day that I left this place that I'd never come back down. Now my $300 silk dress tumbles to a $10 motel floor. I step into your arms and back in time to taste your love once more. He gives me diamonds, you give me chips. You're holding me in a hungry way that I know he never will. You give me what I really need, but he pays the bills. He gives me diamonds, you give me chills. World that's good about being poor. Now I swear that this little girl ain't gonna be no more. You know I'd never leave you, babe, if we could live on love alone. Let's not cry, this ain't goodbye. I just got to get myself back home. He gives me diamonds, you give me chips. You're holding me in a hungry way that I know he never will. You give me what I really need, but he pays the bills. He gives me diamonds, you give me chills. Honey, you're feeling fine, and them diamonds are looking smaller all the time. You give me chills.
Margot was on the show a while back, and we kicked off that song when she was on this show. He gives me diamonds, you give me chills.
For 1981, Ford introduces the 21 MPG pickup. This efficient new Ford breaks the six-cylinder mileage barrier with an estimated EPA MPG of 21 and a highway estimate of 29. Think of it, the 21 MPG pickup. Time was you had to settle for a little import to get that kind of gas mileage. Now Ford delivers it with a Husky 306 in full-size F-150 models that can take payloads as big as 2,500 pounds. Mileage estimates are with four-speed overdrive option. Use for comparison. Your mileage may differ and California estimates are lower. Highway mileage will probably be less than estimated. However, if you're looking for gas mileage that rivals the little imports, but in a full-size, full-powered American pickup, the place to look for it is at your Ford dealer. Stop in and see the pickup that broke the six-cylinder mileage barrier, the 21 MPG Ford. It's designed for the needs of the 80s, and it's built Ford tough.
Ray, I want to play a song. You know, disc jockeys do this every once in a while. I want to play a song I like.
Great. I like the song, too.
You told me this was not one of your best records.
No, I think I could have done a better job of it. It didn't happen to turn out like I really wanted to, but it turned out pretty good, and it did good for us. And of course, Mac Davis wrote it.
And we start out with some burnt pancakes, I believe.
I'm telling you.
And then we move on from there.
Well, I scorched your favorite pan this morning trying to make some pancakes. Spilled the grease and had to stop and mop the floor. Sat there like a little baby crying in my cornflakes. I don't think I can take it anymore. Baby, come home. This is a lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Late last night I woke up trembling with my arms wrapped round your pillow and a lump as big as Texas in my throat. Sat there in the dark and played my guitar till the sun came up and wrote the saddest song I ever wrote. Baby, come home. This is a lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. The lonesomest lonesome, oh, the saddest sad, the loneliest I've ever been alone. You were the best thing this poor boy ever had. Now you're gone. Well, tonight I'm gonna get down on my knees and say a prayer for the first time since I can't remember when. Maybe if I'm lucky when I wake up in the morning, you'll be soft and warm beside me once again. Baby, come home. This is the lonesomest lonesome, lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Baby, come home.
Oh, I like that. Got some strings and horns there, a nice lilt to it. Ray Price, and the song is called The Lonesomest Lonesome.
If you were invited to a potluck supper hosted by your favorite country music stars, the table would feature such dishes as Jack's Mad Scramble, Hank's Singin' Sizzlers, Texas Chuck Wagon Son of a Gun Stew, Minnie's Bacon and Cheese Pie, Billy Joe's Cherry Bubble Cake, and Eggplant a la Tammy. Country cooking. Boy, it's just like country music, one of life's great pleasures. Now, your favorite stars have invited you to see what's cooking at their houses and to share their favorite recipes in the Country Stars Cookbook. Over 100 recipes from soups and salads to main dishes and desserts, each one tried and true. Included in the cookbook are pictures and biographies of the stars as they whip up their favorite recipes. The Country Stars Cookbook can be yours for only $4 by sending a check or money order to Country Cookbook, Box 8, Department R, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203. That's $4 to Country Cookbook, Box 8, Department R, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Ray, can you cook?
Yeah, enough to keep them starving. Yeah. No, I like to cook. When I get a chance, if the kitchen's a big kitchen and I got room, I like to do a lot of cooking.
You still got Blondie Calderon with you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Blondie's been with me almost off and on now for almost 15 years.
And Blondie is Ray's conductor.
Right, right.
But do you need him with the eight-piece road band you have now?
Oh, absolutely.
He plays the piano?
He plays piano. He's one of my right hands, you know, and been with me. He's like a brother.
Ray, here's a fellow that... used to listen to you. He used to tell me about that. He'd listen to my all-night radio show, and
this guy used to come see me in Oklahoma and every place, him and the old man.
Yeah, he was a big country music fan, even though at the time he was into the rock.
He was a big rock star. Sure was.
Conway Twitty.
I threw away the picture of those better days in Dallas. But I can't throw away these pictures in my mind. You're a page of precious memory. I've tried hard to turn. You're standing on a bridge that just won't burn. If only time will heal the hurt, then this may last forever. I may never how it feels to forget. And every time I think about you, those old feelings still return. You're standing on a bridge that just won't burn. On a bridge that just won't burn. But you're standing on a bridge that just won't burn.
Conway Twitty singing A Bridge That Just Won't Burn. The Ralph Emery Show with Ray Price continues now, and we'll take Ronnie Millsap on for a turn, then we'll return to Ray.
I thumb away from L.A. back to Knoxville. I found out those bright lights ain't where I belong. From a phone booth in the rain, I called to tell her I've had a change of dreams, I'm coming home. But tears filled my eyes when I found out she was gone. Smoky Mountain rain keeps on falling. I keep on calling her name. Smoky Mountain. Mountain rain. I waved a diesel down outside a cafe. He said that he was going as far as Gatlinburg. I climbed up in the cab all wet and cold and lonely. I wiped my eyes and told him about her. To find her, can you make these big wheels burn? Smoky Mountain rain keeps on falling. I keep on calling.
can't blame her for letting go. A woman needs someone warm to hold. I feel the rain running down my face. I'll find her no matter what it takes. Smoky mountain rain, stop falling. Keep on calling.
Ronnie Millsap, Ronnie with the Smoky Mountain Rain. My guest is Ray Price. Ray, I'm sure a lot of your friends are listening. They're wondering why I didn't ask you about the racehorses or the chickens. And what'd you do? You used to have some racehorses, didn't you?
I donated. Ralph, I really quit the business about 8 years ago. And I would play 4 or 5 days a year. And I was trying to raise my horses and make it that way and have some home life. And you know what you think about when you're an entertainer. You say, boy, if I can just get it going good enough, I could get to spend some time at home and everything. Well, I tried it for 5 years and it almost got me down. I missed it so much. And finally, I just decided I'd do it. And I gave every horse I had to Texas A&M and all my trailers and stallions and brood mares, because they have a nice breeding program and they sell the foals and the stallion services and they make money.
Mm-hmm.
So I gave it to them, gave all my chickens up. I've got 4 beagle hound dogs that I got, that I'm crazy about. That's all I got left. And I went back to work and I'm back full force. And of course the first effort was the Willie Nelson novel.
Not bad effort.
It's a good way to start. Start at the top. I went to the head one.
You proud of Willie Nelson?
I'm very proud of Willie Nelson. I'm proud of everybody that I've ever been able or fortunate enough to have helped. Maybe that's why God put me here. I don't know.
Have any idea that kid back here playing poker on your bus would become the giant star that he is today?
Well, I knew that if determination would do it, he would, in hard work. Willie's a hard worker and determined, and I've seen him literally scratch his way, and you have to route to the top. I'm proud of him.
All right. Ray, earlier we played Crazy Arms by you and Willie. I thought I'd just turn you loose on Crazy Arms one more time here.
Okay.
How blue ain't the word for the way that I feel, and the storm's brewing in this heart of mine. This ain't no crazy dream. I know that it's real. You're someone else's love now. You're not mine. Crazy arms that reach to hold somebody new. For my yearning heart keeps saying you're not mine. My troubled mind knows soon to another you'll be well. And that's why I'm lonely all the time. Treasured dreams I have for you and me, and take all the love I thought was mine. Someday my crazy arms may hold somebody new, but now I'm so lonely all the time. Crazy arms that reach to hold somebody new, for my yearning heart keeps saying you're not mine. My trouble mine, no soon to another you'll be well, and that's why I'm lonely all the time.
Our guest, Ray Price, and Crazy Arms. Friends, this is Ralph Emery. I want to tell you about one of my favorite things. It's the Music City News, the country music newspaper from Nashville. As a subscriber to Music City News, you can read behind-the-scenes stories about the stars, enjoy exclusive pictures, and learn about their newest record releases. But most importantly, Music City News offers you the right to vote for your favorite country music star in the Music City News Cover Award Show on national television in June. Mail your check or money order for $9 today, and you will save more than 25%, because by acting now, you'll receive 3 months free. It means you're getting 15 issues for the price of 12. So rush your check for $9 today to Music City News, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. That's $9 to Music City News, Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. Ray, you know, I've been through listening to a whole bunch of your albums. Is there one single song in your entire career that you would say was the most important, either from a standpoint of sales, popularity, or that people remember you by?
Well, Ralph, I don't know where I'd be making a mistake by saying the thing that I'm going to say, but it seems to me like that somebody in the radio was telling me that every year the radio stations have a private survey of their own for the most played record of the year. And this song, the last count I had won that every year for 8 years. It's For the Good Times.
Okay.
And that has to be the song, because it was, like I say, an answer to a prayer for me. I got it. It's been fantastic. It's the most beautiful love song I've ever heard.
That's bigger than Crazy Arms, Release Me, Heartaches by the Numbers, and all the rest.
Right.
Next up on our show, we'll bring a pretty girl to our microphone. My friends, here's Donna Fargo.
Yesterday started no different than 100 days before. He reached out and touched me before my feet could touch the cold. As I lay beside him and the thoughts of the moment filled my mind, loving him for my last time. But seeing is believing, and believing is the feeling that you feel when the love and the feeling's gone. Everything we've ever been or anything will be again. Packed up his bag and moved along. It's hard to
a memory. Oh, but seeing is believing, and believing is the feeling that you feel when the love and the feeling's gone. Everything we've ever been or anything will be again. Packed up his bag and moved along.
Donna Fargo, Donna with Seeing is Believing. Ray, let's play an oldie here. Why don't you bring on this?
All right. Yeah, listen, I like this act. I've worked with them in Missouri and places, and they're really good, and they sing great. Dave and Sugar, and Gotta Quit Looking at You, Baby.
I gotta quit looking at you, baby, or someone's gonna know. Gotta quit looking at you, baby, or my life's gonna show.
Either one would tell the world, but neither one is free.
So we'll pretend that we're just friends to everyone around. Hide feelings that we have till the sun goes down.
I gotta quit looking at you, baby, or someone's gonna know. Gotta quit looking at you, baby, or my life's gonna show. Gotta quit looking at you, baby, when you're looking back at me.
No one knows, we might know our fates. We hide a light from prying eyes, some dark smoke to play.
It's hard to keep my hands off you, but you know it has to be. Till I can tell the world I'm yours and you belong to me.
I've got to quit looking at you, baby, or someone's gonna know. Gotta quit looking at you, baby, or my life's gonna show.
Dave and Sugar with Gotta Quit Looking at You, Baby.
Truckers across America have cast their vote, and the winner is Ford. Ford trucks have outsold their closest competition. That's not surprising because these redesigned Fords were the first new trucks of the 80s. And now the new Ford trucks for 81 are at your Ford dealer. New Ford 4x4s and Broncos. The first with optional overdrive transmission. And they offer new optional automatic locking hubs, too. And here's another Ford first. Automatic overdrive. It's optional in 81 Ford pickups, and no other truck has anything like it. This new automatic transmission shifts into overdrive at about 45 miles an hour automatically. See all the 81 Ford pickups at your Ford dealer now. Regular cab pickups, super cabs, four-wheel drive pickups, rugged six-wheelers. They're designed for the needs of the 80s, and they're built Ford tough.
I'm going to get back to Ray Price here. Ray, I'm scratching around here. There's a name that I haven't brought up in this.
Mm-hmm.
Mel Tillis.
Mel?
Weren't you the fellow that named him Flutter Lips?
Yeah, I guess I am. Places. No, now, wait a minute. I might not have been. I believe Wayne Walker is the one.
Oh, really? Wayne was his very close friend.
Absolutely.
But you were the first guy I ever heard say that.
I used to say it to him. I was the only one to get away with it, I think. In fact, Mel and I are awful good friends, I think, or hope. And I met Mel at Tampa, Florida, and he had a song that I thought was a good song, and I talked to him about it, and Webb Pierce recorded it. It's a big song.
Is that I Ain't Never?
I Ain't Never, yeah.
Ray, I never did link up why you gave up veterinary medicine. You were going to be a veterinarian and got into music.
Well, what happened, Ralph, of course, always when I was a little kid, I used to wish that I was a singer, you know. And in the country, and lonely little boy or something, a boy liked to sing to the world. And that's what I asked for, and that's what Jesus gave me. And I've been after it ever since. But when I stayed away from it through the Marine Corps part and everything, and when I got into college, there was a group of us guys that used to go out to a little nightclub called Roy's House Cafe, and we'd put on impromptu shows. And I'd sing country music. And so the guitar player wrote country songs. He wanted to know if I'd go demonstrate some to a publisher, and I did in Dallas. And I went down there to Jim Beck's studio. They asked me would I come back the next day after they heard me. And I come back the next day, and they gave me a contract on Bullet Records, and that turned my world upside down. I found out where I wanted to be.
Been going ever since.
Ever since.
Ray, we're going to have to wrap this up. I thought we'd go back into the album, San Antonio Rose, with you and Willie.
Okay.
And another old song. You did this the first time by yourself, didn't you?
Right, and it was a big song for me, a number one song. Hank Cochran wrote it, and I think it deserves to be number one all over again.
You make my eyes run over all the time. You're happy when I'm out of my mind. You don't love me, but you won't let me be. Don't you ever get tired of hurting me. You must think I look bad with a smile, for you haven't let me wear one in such a long, long while. Still I keep running back. Why must this be? Don't you ever get tired of hurting me.
Someone must have hurt you long ago. But why take revenge on one who loved you so? You won't love me, and you won't let me be. Don't you ever get tired of hurting me. You must think that I look bad with a smile, for you haven't let me have one in such a long, long while. How can this be? Don't you ever get tired of hurting me. Don't you ever get tired of hurting me.
Our guest, Ray Price, with Willie Nelson, and Don't You Ever Get Tired of Hurting Me. Ray, I've really enjoyed this.
Me too, Ralph. I don't want to wait 5 years next time.
Oh, no. If I can catch you coming through Nashville, I'd love to have you come and sit and talk with us.
I'll let you know.
Our guest, Ray Price, one of the giants of country music. And our show has been brought your way by the giant truck builder of America, Ford Trucks. And this is Ralph Emery for Ray Price, and we thank you for listening.